Hi, my name is Trevor Dally, and I'm with LMI Technologies, and today we're going to open up a G5516. We'll start by opening up the box. Take the foam off the top. Some mounting bolts. More foam. And here's the 5516. And that's the unboxing process. All right, let's mount this G5516 to our system. We have a plate right here. And the box came with the 90 millimeter screws, and so this won't work with our plates. We have 15 millimeter screws for this system. Okay, you can tighten down the bolts. Okay, now I'm ready to install this on my system. It is important to know that this sensor is 21 kilograms. It is heavy. So if you need a friend, you might want to ask. Now that the sensor is installed, we can plug in our power and Ethernet connection and also an I/O cable for our encoder signal. So it's important to have an encoder signal with this device that is very resolute. So we can unplug these caps. And luckily for me, my system's already set up for this sensor. And I'm just gonna plug in the corresponding cables. There's the I/O cable. And my power cable. Now there is a status light on here. You should see a power LED light on when you have power. Now that everything's installed and the sensor's powered on, we can go to the default IP address, which will be 192.168.110. And we should be able to access the sensor's web UI. My sensor is on now. I'm gonna put a random target in there, just my phone, and we can get our first scan with our G5516.
Now that the web page is accessed, we can make sure we're at this maintenance page and we can check the software version and make sure that the software version is the latest. We can go to lmi3d.com to just check that. And if it's not, you can download the firmware, press this upgrade button and properly upgrade your sensor. So since that our sensor is the most up-to-date firmware, we can go to our scan settings and can turn the sensor on. You'll want to make sure that your object is within the field of view of the sensor, which mine is. And at this point, we can go to our image and we can just double check that we've got a good exposure. So for me, I might want to reduce it slightly just so that I've got maybe a couple of pixels across. But maybe I can reduce that just a little bit more. And if need be, we can use multiple exposure to get those multiple layers. So go to surface. We're in time mode right now. So let's switch over to encoder. I can go to my alignment tab, insert my encoder value for my system, and specify an encoder spacing. I'll just do about 10 microns. Okay. Now, look at my surface settings. I've got about 100 millimeter scan. Maybe let's do 20 millimeters. And I can start the sensor and move my object. Okay, now we got our first scan with the G5516. So if we want multiple layers, we can go down to our layers, increase it. Let's do 2 layers. And also we can check this layer sorting order. By default, it's gonna go by intensity, then top to bottom. Sometimes I like to just select top to bottom, just so we make sure. And we can go to our exposure mode and do multiple exposures just so we can get that second one. Let's try 40. Okay. If I take a snapshot and look at my outputs, we can see my multiple layers. And I can hide my exposure 1 to see my exposure 2. And I can see my second layer. Maybe I want to go a little bit higher. Let's try double that. Just so I get a little bit more feedback on that second layer. And so the data will fill in the first layer first, and then the second layer. Okay. Let's go back to surface mode. Acquire intensity and get another scan. Okay, there's our second scan. And if I pan in 3D, we can see that we have two layers here. I can deselect the top layer to see the second. And that's about it.